A very good day to all of you. Computer Shiksha is supported by. In the previous class, you learnt about the remaining options of the file and edit menu. Do you remember which formulas you had learnt about? In the last class, you learnt about some formulas related to date and time, like days, weekday, weeks in year, etc. Before we begin today's class, let us revise what we had earlier learnt. Can you tell what option you will need to use to send your document to some other user? With the send option, you can send your document to any other user. Can you tell which option will you need to use if you want to get information about your file, like which is our file, is the file saved or not, on which date was it saved, etc. To get to know all this information, you will use the property option. Can you tell why is the page break preview used? With the help of page break preview, you can see your page till where you have typed something, till where you have not given any space, and you can type in this space also. Can you tell if you want to see what changes have been made in your document, then what option will you use? You will use compare document to see changes that may have been made to your document. Why do we use the paste special option? When you copy or cut and then you want to paste the same in different formats, then you will use the paste special option. If you want to move or copy or delete your spreadsheet, then what option will you use? For this, you will use the sheet option of the edit menu. Let us now begin today's class. Now, all of you switch on your computers and using any of the methods taught to you, open the spreadsheet file. In today's class, you will all revise the remaining options of the file and edit menu. And besides this, you will revise the formulas you have learned earlier and will also learn some new formulas. First of all, you create the data or look at the picture being shown to you and type out the data in your sheet. Now, all of you save this file. Let us now watch the video and see how to save the file. Let us watch this video and learn how we can save our CalC file. This is actually a revision. You already know that you can use the shortcut command or you can use the file menu and save from there. So go to this file menu, click on it, click on save. A box opens which gives you the option of a location where you want to save on your computer. So if we want to save it on desktop, we will click on desktop. Then we type a file name for this file. So we have typed class 4 and then we click on the save button. So this file gets saved with the name of class 4. As soon as you save it, even here on your sheet that you're working on the CalC sheet, you can see in the title bar, class 4 name has been given to this file. If you want to see where it has been saved, minimize this and then look for the desktop. On the desktop, you can see there is a file existing by the name of class 4 which has been saved. You can go to the taskbar now and open your spreadsheet again where you were working. So this is how you can save your file. Using the templates option, show how you can organize some helpline numbers like police helpline number, women helpline number, and computer shiksha helpline number, etc. Let us watch the video and see how these contacts can be organized using the templates option. Watch this video now to understand how we can use the template option to save helpline numbers. So to use the template option on our Calc sheet, we will go to the file menu, click there, and then click on templates option. And first we will click on save, because we want to save a new template. So we can now give a name. A box opens, it says new template, and we have typed helpline as the name, and we click on OK. So now we have a template known as helpline. Go back to edit file menu, click on templates, and this time click on organize. A box opens. Since we have saved our template in my templates, click there, look for helpline, click on that, and then you can click on the drop down button in commands to edit, because we want to enter the helpline numbers now. So we go to sheet 2, where we will key in the helpline numbers. Remember that you can drag these columns to make them bigger or smaller. So first one we are writing is the woman helpline in A1 cell, woman helpline number. And then in B1, we will type the number 1039. Next, let's type the police helpline number, which is 100. So we type in this 100. Next, let's type computer shiksha helpline number. Once again, notice that we need to increase our A column width. You can do so as is being shown in the video. Keep your cursor here and then drag it towards the right side. You can increase the size of column B also, the width of column B also similarly, so that you can type the number. Now we are typing the number for computer shiksha helpline, which is 99 106 23 004. So now once we have finished typing this, we can go back to file, go to templates, and click on save, because we now are saving with the same name. Let's type helpline. Remember earlier when we had saved helpline, there were no numbers in it. So we click on OK. And it says that it's already in use. So we can click on yes, that we want to overwrite this, because earlier there were no numbers. Now we have saved the helpline as numbers. So if you click on file, go to template, now click on organize, so that you can export this template. As soon as you click, go to my templates, click on helpline, click on commands, and click on export template. A box opens asking you where you want to save it. So if you want to save it in desktop with the name helpline 1, we click on save button. We can close this. So now this has been saved as helpline numbers, as helpline 1. So if you want to see, you can minimize this and look on the desktop. You will find helpline 1 template is existing. So now wherever you want to use these list of numbers, when you open that, you can see that your list is available. So now you have it on the desktop, and you can continue to use this wherever you want in your work. You can come back to the taskbar and open your file again for further work. Next, use the header option and type out practice class on top of all your sheets. Now, all of you look at your spreadsheet document and say on which sheet you are currently working and what is its name, like sheet 1, sheet 2, sheet 3, etc. Now, Go to the second sheet, change its name and type the names of some of the formulas that you learned in the last class, like weekday, is leap year, days in month, week in year, etc. Now, type the name of the formula in the A1 row and then below that, show how you will use these formulas. First, go ahead and use the date formula and then use the time formula and lastly, use the month formula. Watch the video and understand how these tasks have to be done. In this video, we will see how we can use the text formula to get the day, month or year from a given date. So we have already got this data here in which some dates have been given to us and we have the title of day, month and year already written. So let's apply the formula here for day. So what we do is we use the text formula equal to text, begin bracket and then select the date. After that, put a semicolon and then put the format in which you want the day to appear. So we put double inverted commas and then type DD, close double inverted commas, bracket close and then press enter. And you can see it shows 02, which is the day in the date 12/02/16. If the formula is typed differently, we type equal to text, begin bracket, and then select the date, put a semicolon, and then double inverted commas, and we type DDDD, 4 times D, close the inverted commas and close the bracket, press enter, you will see the day appears in words like Friday. If you want to get the day for all the other dates, you can just click on the black dot on the right bottom and drag it downwards. So you can see all the days for all these dates in the other rows are also shown to you. Next, we want to find the month by using the text formula for a given day. So the formula we use equal to text, begin bracket, select the date, semicolon, then inverted commas, double inverted commas, and then MMMM, 4 times M, close the inverted commas, double inverted commas, close the bracket, press enter, and you will see that this month it is 12, so December gets written in this cell. Now if you notice, all the other dates are also of the December month. So if you just drag this formula from this cell by dragging the black dot, all the other rows will also show December as the month. Next, if we change the date, one of the dates, the last date we are changing, note carefully that the day and the month will change accordingly. So we are typing 3, 14, 16 or 2016. So this is the March month and the day also has changed to Monday. So this is how you will use the text formula. Now let's also use the text formula for finding the year from any date. Let's change another date here. We are typing 6/21/2017. As soon as you press enter, both the day and the month have changed. Let's use the text formula for the year. Equal to text, begin bracket, select the date, semicolon, double inverted commas, and then the format, which now will be YYYY, four times Y. Close the double inverted commas and close the bracket, press enter, and you can see it will show you the year 2016. And you can drag this formula down. By now you all know how to do that. So you can just click on the dot there and drag it downwards. You can also use two times double left click. And you can see that the years 2016, 2016, 2017 have appeared. So this is how you will use the text formula for getting day, month and year of a date. Next, use the weekday formula and say what was the week on the date of 05/05/2008, which is 5th of May 2008. If you face a problem, then watch the video and learn how this is to be done. Let us watch this video now and see how we can use the weekday formula to find the number of week from a particular date. We have selected the sheet 2, which we had renamed as class 4. And here in C1 cell, let's type the title weekday because we want to apply the formula here. And in the next cell, let's type the formula for weekday, which is equal to weekday. Start the bracket and then type the number, meaning the date. So we are typing 5/5/2008, then semicolon and type. So the type 1 will give you beginning with Sunday. Otherwise, you can choose to begin with Monday for the weekdays. And then you press enter, you get 1 as the answer. So this is how you can find the week day from a given date using the weekday formula. Similarly, use the correct formula to find out how many weeks were there in the years 1997 and 2000. Let us now watch the video and see how the week in year formula is to be used. By watching this video now, we are going to once again practice the formula for weeks in year. So we want to know how many weeks are there in a year. So we are first typing a title here in E1 cell where we want to find the weeks in year. So since we are finding the weeks in a year, we can give a title like week count, because we are counting the number of weeks in that year. So we give that title, and in the next cell, let's apply the formula. For any formula, you have to first use equal to. So we type equal to weeks in year. Remember to type the correct spelling, weeks in year, then begin bracket, which is shift 9. And then give the year, the date, which is we are using 1997. Close the bracket, press enter, and you get an answer of 52, which is the number of weeks in that particular year. Similarly, if we want to do this again, we can type equal to weeks in year, begin the bracket, and then type the year for the date. So once again, we are trying 1997, close the bracket, press enter, and again you get 52 as an answer. So this is how you can use the formula for weeks in year on your Calci sheet. Next, use the correct formula to find out how many days are there between 15 February 2017 and 15 February 2015. Let us watch the video and see which formula you can use to find out the days. Let us now watch this video and see how we can find the number of days between two dates. So for this, we are again using the same class 4 sheet, which is actually the sheet 2. In F1 column, let's type the title for this. Let's type just days because we are finding the number of days. And let's type in two dates. For using this formula, the days formula, it is good to type the dates also using the date formula so that the days formula works perfectly. If you type in just the date directly, the days formula may not work. So we are typing a date is equal to date 2017 semicolon and then the month and the date. And close the bracket. We are also typing a second date is equal to date 2015 semicolon, then the month and the day 15 and close the bracket and press enter. So we have these two dates now. One is 2017, the other is 2015. So we apply the days formula in the F2 cell equal to days, begin the bracket, then select the first date, 2017 date, put a semicolon, select the second date, which is the 2015 date. So there are almost 2 years in between, then close the bracket and press enter. So this gives you the number of days between these two dates. So you can see it gives you an answer of 731 days which are there between these two dates. So this is how you can use the days formula. Now all of you practice the use of compare document and also tell what happens with its use. Let us see the video and learn from it. Let us watch this video and practice the use of compare document. So whichever document you want to compare, you will first go to the edit menu, go to compare document. It opens a box for you to select the document that you want to compare. So for whichever document you want to compare, you select that document. You can select first where your document is. So if it is in desktop, you can just scroll up and down and look for the document and open that document which you want to use. For instance, here we are opening a document which is already existing in the desktop. And as soon as we open it, it is in the record mode, which means that any changes are being recorded here. So it shows you all the in the document, it shows you with red outline the cells on which some change have been made. And then you can, in this box, it shows you that you can accept or reject the changes that have been made so that you know whatever changes have been made. Also, in the document, if you make any changes here, it will again get highlighted with this red outline. So right now, the record mode is on. So any changes that you're making in these documents will get highlighted. So this way, you can compare a document which is already stored on your computer with the document, a later version of that document in which some changes have been made. You can see even in sheet 1, the red outlines are there for all the cells which have been used. So this way, you can use the compare document. If you want to come out of this record mode, go to edit, click on changes, and then unselect the record mode. So unselect the record option. You can say yes to this message, and then your document appears in the normal view without those highlighting, without the changes being highlighted. Now show how you will get to know the properties of this file. Like, when was this file saved, what date was it saved on, etc. In case you have a doubt, then watch the video and learn how you can check the properties of your document. In this video, let us see how we can use the properties option to know about details of our file. So if you want to know the properties, we need to go to the file menu and click on it and then choose the properties option. A box opens, and from the tabs which are there, select the general tab for information. Now this general tab in the properties box for this file gives you all the relevant information. It gives you the title, it gives you the location, the type, the size of the file. So you can see here is the title, class 4, and the type of this is, it's an open document, spreadsheet document. Then the location is shown, it's saved on desktop, its size is shown that it has 9012 bytes, it is shown when it was created on 31st of January 2017, when it was modified. So all this information is available to you in this general tab of properties. Let us now learn about some new formulas. The first one is network days. Using this formula, you can find out the working day between two dates. For this, you will need to define the dates of the holiday yourself. The formula you will need to use for this is equal to network days, bracket open, start date, semicolon, end date, semicolon, holiday, and then close bracket. Let us watch the video and understand how the network days formula is used. Let us watch this video and understand how we can get the net working days between two dates. So for this, in the G1 column, let's type a title, net work days, and then apply the formula in the next cell, which will be equal to net work days. Then begin the bracket, and you have to give a start date and an end date, and you also have to define if you want the holidays in between. So we have selected the first date as 15-2-2017, and the semicolon, and then the second date or the end date as 3rd March 2017. Close the bracket, press enter, and it shows you that the net work days between these two dates is 13, as the answer is showing here. So this is how you can get the net work days between two dates on your Calc sheet. The next formula is for weeks. Using this, you can find out the day of the week between two dates. The formula you will use for this will be is equal to weeks, bracket open, the first date, semicolon, the second date, semicolon, zero, and then bracket close. For example, is equal to weeks, bracket, 12/01/2016, semicolon, 12/02/2016, semicolon, zero, and bracket close. Let us watch the video and learn from it. Let us watch this video now and see how we can find the number of weeks between two given dates. So, since we want to find the number of weeks between two given dates, let's type a title in the H1 cell. We can type week. We're typing week days. And then we'll apply the formula week days. But remember, we are trying to find out the number of weeks between two dates and not the week days. So this is wrong. We should have just applied the formula for weeks. So we will again change the title because we are just trying to find the number of weeks between two dates. Now let's apply the formula, which is weeks, W-E-E-K-S, and then begin the bracket. Then you have to select the start date, semicolon, end date. So we select the start date, put a semicolon. We've selected the 15-2-2017 as the start date. Then we put a semicolon and select the end date, which we'll select as 3-3-2017. Now if we close the bracket, you can see what is happening. It is showing an error because in this formula, we also have to give a type at the end. So you have to type equal to weeks, then begin the bracket, choose a start date, semicolon, an end date, and a type. If you type 1, it will count from Sundays. If you type 0, it will count from Monday. So you have to do that. We have typed 0 here. We have selected the two dates. Close the bracket, press enter, and it shows you that there are 2 weeks between these two dates, 15-2-2017 and 3-3-2017. So this is how you can use this formula to get the number of weeks between any two dates. Remember that you have to type the type also in the end for this formula to be effective. Now you can practice using some formulas on your own. Now all of you use these four formulas and practice with them and then also tell what happens with them. Is equal to days in month bracket 30-02-2012 bracket close. You can use this to find the day of this month and get to know the number of days in the month. Is equal to minute bracket time bracket close. Is equal to second bracket time bracket close. Today's class will end here. So save your file and then properly shut down your computer. In today's class, all of you learned about options of the file and edit menus. And you also practiced using date and time related formulas and also learned some new formulas. Computer Shiksha is supported by. Thank you.